start out with a little review. Here's the internal thoracic, staying inside the thorax. And here is the superficial cervical artery. Okay, so as we're coming around that first rib, we are the axillary artery. The first branch off that, which is often broken, is the external thoracic artery. And it's going to supply the superficial pectoralis muscles. Sometimes this artery actually does come off of the superficial cervical artery, so you might want to watch out for that. But just remember, it's not so much where it's coming from, but where it's going. And so you can see here's where it supplies the superficial pectoralis muscles. Next one coming off, another small one, is the lateral thoracic artery. Lateral thoracic artery, we can see, is going into the deep pectoralis muscles, and then also has this branch here, which passes by the axillary lymph nodes. Okay. We continue on down the axillary artery. We have a nice large branch coming off here. This is the subscapular. And you can see, if you move over here, that subscapular is going to continue running up the medial surface of the scapula, going dorsally. Okay, coming off of that, we have one branch that runs here caudally. This is the thoracodorsal artery. And then we have sometimes one, sometimes multiple branches that are just passing deep and going laterally. And these are going to be our caudal, circumflex, humeral arteries. Okay, now the next artery that comes off our axillary artery, let's reflect this out of our way. Since we had a caudal circumflex humeral, we must have a cranial circumflex humeral. And this is coming up towards our, it's not real exposed here, but our coracobrachialis muscle. So that's kind of a landmark for finding that. Sometimes this guy is going to slip down here and actually come off the subscapular, but usually it comes off right after. And so at this point, when this cranial circumflex humeral comes off, we now become the brachial artery. Now, one that the book doesn't cover, but I like to point out just because it helps reduce confusion, this is the deep brachial artery. Okay, as we course distally here, we have our collateral ulnars coming off. On occasion, there might be two of them. And then this one here, since we had a deep brachial, we must have a superficial brachial. That superficial brachial, once it crosses the elbow onto the anabrachium, will become the cranial superficial anabrachial artery. Another one that he doesn't mention in the book that I like to point out just because reducing confusion here, this one that's going right into the biceps brachii is the bicipital artery. Okay, as we come on down, we find one here that's going to go transversely across the elbow or cubit, and that's the transverse cubital. Okay, to continue on down, this is one you don't have to worry about. And then we have a big guy here that is going straight laterally between the radius and ulna. So that's going to be the common interosseous. And its first branch is going to come off and go right across the bone of the ulna there. You can see that. That is the ulnar. That is my landmark because I make sure it's going over that bone. Okay, our common interosseous is going to continue laterally. The going to branch into two branches. The cranial interosseous, which is going to supply the muscles on the lateral surface, the anabrachium, and then it's going to give off this one, which is coursing distally. And if, okay, so they didn't transect the pronator quadratus as some of the animals show, but you can follow that artery, that caudal interosseous artery, down the limb that way. Yeah, so you see a little bit there going distally. Okay. So this one here, which is going deep into the antebrachial muscles, is the deep antebrachial artery. Coming on down, when the common interosseous comes off, I forgot to mention, then our brachial artery then becomes the median artery. Now remember, it's median with an N, not medial. If you put medial, you'll get it wrong. So median artery, and it's going to give off a small branch. Where did that small branch go? Right. No. I was just tracing it earlier. Trying to ride. Yep, I guess that is it right there. And that little artery running right along here, which is going to be more medial than the median, is the radial artery. So we come on down, and then we pass between the tendons of the deep digital flexor and the superficial digital flexor here, and course on down into the paw, and we see this superficial palmar arch, which is then going to give off branches that are going to go down to the digits. Joining it here is going to be that caudal interosseous artery, creating an arch. The radial is going to join more into a deep arch. Yeah.